Good morning, friends. Yesterday, my camera died while I was chatting you guys up about pasture management practices and stuff, and how we don't want to walk through the pasture too many times, how we don't want to put cars on the pasture. I was talking to you about the concept of coming loaded and leaving loaded, which means that I will carry as many things as possible with me in one trip, so that I don't have to make as many trips. So like right now, I came out to the pasture with both my feed buckets to get the birds motivated to leave the other paddock, which some of them are still being dumb over there. Motivates them to leave so I have space and I'm not stepping on them while I do the waters and move the fence. So when I'm done with this, I will check trash. That's what I do while I'm out here too, is I check the new paddock every day for trash, because there's a lot of weird pieces of metal and stuff out here and we don't want the birds getting injured. That would be bad. Then when I take those back up to the barn, I will bring waters out on the next trip. So I'm always trying to have minimal foot traffic in the pasture if I can, just because it compacts the pasture like we were talking about. Hello, Bones. So here we go. I'm gonna set you guys up and move these things. So I'm kind of worried about top watering my tulips because I don't know what I'm doing. So I figured I would just flood water them really good, just to make sure that they're hydrated enough through the bloom. I really need to read more about them. I've just been so busy. And hopefully this works out okay. I think I need to turn the pressure down. But then I have onions right there too, and onions are generally flood irrigated, so I'm trying to keep those very moist. I'm honestly thinking that I could mow my lawn in some places. I might remove my rock border on this side and mow it really good before replacing the rocks, because it's really long in some spots. Why are you yelling?
look good. That does not look good at all. Oh my gosh. That does not look good. There's literally smoke coming out from the bottom. Tons of it. He can't go! He's stuck! He's stuck, Mom. He's stuck. He's going! Whoa! Whoa! Oh my god!
There he goes, you guys!
That does not look good! He's just
gonna... Adam, that's the smoke that a monster truck does! That's what a monster truck does!
That's what a monster truck does!
Jeez, that does not look good. Well, bye-bye.
Here you go.
Yep. And he's back. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Yeah, it's naked. Okay.
Okay, so today is butchering day. Spencer is off with my uncle getting things prepared, and the girls and I are here.
And my mom broke her foot.
I know, we'll talk about that. There it is. It's wrapped in press and seal cling wrap. Because I don't want it to get wet or bloody or gutty or anything like that. Because I don't know how long I'm going to have this splint on until they can get us into the orthopedic.
And we found it.
So Spencer is getting things set up. And we're cleaning up the house. And my mom got some food started for us because I'm crippled. It's not ideal to be doing this, obviously, with my leg broken, but the day was scheduled, and unfortunately the butchering is really time sensitive. The birds were 8 weeks on Tuesday. They're all to weight and looking really good, and so it needs to happen now, especially because Spencer can't really be doing all of my chores and taking care of me and the kids and having a full-time job and all that stuff. So my mom is a rock star. She's here to help me. And the girls have been super helpful. So we will take you guys along with us for the butchering today. It should be lots of fun. I'll be sitting down the entire time, so that'll be new.
Yes.
So yeah, we'll see you out there.
I thought you might need this for your tulip posting, for your tulip vlogging. Thought you might need this, Mommy.
You're so smart. Will you take Mickey's bottle and go wash that out?
All the tulips.
Where is it?
It's right there on the, he's got it in his hand. It just looks like it's got icky water in it or milk.
I see a pink one.
Yep, so we just came out here. I was trying to film it on my phone, but my stinking phone died. Our tulips bloomed. They were barely opening up the day I got injured, but yesterday morning they were starting to open, and I just was out of it, so I didn't really get any footage of it. So exciting. What a nice gift for a crippled homesteader. Okay, I'm laying back down with my foot elevated for a little bit before we head out to butcher. I tell you what, this is the biggest lesson in letting go and releasing control and stuff, because this is my thing. But you know what is so great is that over the last, please stop, go outside. The greatest part about all this is that over the last 5 years, my family has learned how to do all of this, and so they virtually don't need my help. I have taught them well, or Spencer and I have taught them well, so everybody has a job. Everybody knows what the end goal is. We all know what we're doing. So that makes me feel a lot better and not feel so bad, because I definitely feel a fair amount of guilt and stress. But the fact that my family knows what they're doing, and we have so many hands, makes all of this not as distressing, I guess, on me. So I'm excited to get it done. One by one?
Yes.
One by one by one.
Yes.
Hello, my babies. My chicken nugs.
We don't need
on their last.
We can hang one, and then when we're done with the other one, and then we're gonna do two.
Okay. They look so good. Hi, birdies. We're gonna get this done. Okay, so a little information here while I stand on crutches and everybody else gets things set up. So, we're 8 weeks. Goes by super fast. They were fed for the last time last night. It's good practice to restrict food like 8 hours before butcher so that their crops aren't full. For those of you that don't know, the crop is a little pouch right at the beginning of their digestive system. So they basically, chickens ingest their food and it goes into the crop where the water and the food all goes. It kind of ferments in there and then it digests slowly. Because birds or chickens don't have a stomach, they have a gizzard where they actually eat little bits of rocks and sand. And that is what actually grinds their food in the gizzard. It's kind of like their stomach. It's a strong muscular organ. So we restrict food the last like 8 hours. I mean, sometimes 24 hours, up to 24 hours, I guess, before butcher. But we fed them for the last time last night. So that by the time we're doing this, their crops are empty. And it's a lot less messy. It can be really messy when you have full crops. Because obviously it's full of food and it's a lot easier to get the crop out when it's completely empty. Did you already do the deed in there? Will that hose come any closer to me? The hose? I just want to, because I'm going to basically eviscerate right here, I think, and I'll be able to spray.
In that direction?
I think so. I don't, I guess I'll have to see how it goes the first time around. I was going to bring my cutting board with, and then I forgot it, so I had a big white cutting board, and I forgot to bring it, so I'll just.
Right on the table.
Yep. Did you guys clean these off?
Yep.
Okay. Yep, I think I'll just eviscerate right here and I can just spray this direction.
Hi, Buggy.
They don't look clean, but I would just spray.
Oh yeah, this is the same one we did back in Sisters, I'm pretty sure.
I wiped them down, that
was
it.
Yeah, we'll be fine.
And these are sterilized. Washed inside, lids, outside, the whole thing.
Awesome.
Well, they're pretty clean.
You're not going to be able to sit on my lap because I got to butcher chickens. I can hold you for just a second, okay? But I'm going to be butchering chickens here in about 5 minutes. I love you. You want to say hi to the camera? You say hi. No, this way. You say, hi, YouTube.
Hi.
Hi. It is freezer camp day. Isn't it?
Look at this.
But that is scared me.
Hey, it's mine.
Today is butchering day!
Alright, Bubby. Go in there and see what Dad's doing. You wanna go see?
Yeah.
Go in the barn and see what Dad's doing. You probably apologize to him for being naughty.
Cool.
This will work super well.
Disgusting boiled chicken!
Did you not get it all the way?
Is your water not hot enough?
No, it's hot enough.
Oh, okay. Where'd all the feathers go? I didn't see them come out.
Yeah, they're in a pile down there.
Oh, okay. Must not have just...
The fucking wiring in that thing is all wonky. You gotta, like, it just shook and turned itself up. Now, you might have a few nerves in it still.
Attempt with four-wheelers, a drone, engines, and a truck. What turned out to be a mannequin with long flowing hair clinging to the side of a cliff. I think this is what they call art in California.
Hi!
No!
My bush jet, my. I can't even see it. I have to show you guys. It's so amazing. Like, it is amazing. Look at them. So cute. There are sunflowers and zinnias. And oh my gosh, it's just amazing.
I found a sunny. Nope, that's not a sunny. That's sunflower.
Oh my gosh, look at all of them. So adorable.
And look at my bed. Look at her bed. It's so green.
Her bed is super adorbs.
Why your knees going to go in?
Yeah.
Is that a baby carrot?
And most important of the club is this guy.
Look at that! And look at our yellow bird.
Yeah, look at
come over here! Come over here, down here!
Everything's booming. And look at that, look at that, look at that. Look at that. Lilac. This is a lilac bush.
So alive.
Oh, and you have to see mom's little friends. Look at that.
What is that, man? And look, white thing.
It's a bunny.
That's a bunny tail seed.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Oh yeah, I would show you. I would show you my dance, but I'm dancing right now. I'll just show you. Wait a minute.
Yeah. Do a pose.
Hey guys.
The guard is blue. The guard is blue. And pose.
Hi guys.
Well, that's it for today. Bye bye.
We're safe. You're a good boy. I know, but we're safe. You're such a good dog. We're safe, I promise. Yeah. You're a good boy. You're a really good boy coming in here to check on mom when you get scared. Yeah. Those are just airplanes. You're such a good little pup.
Hello, friends. So I haven't picked my camera up in over a week, I don't think. Wearing my phone charger around my neck because I can't carry stuff because I have no hands. That's why I haven't picked my camera up either in over a week, because crutching around, you have no hands. But I just came to the window to look outside at my garden, and I had to show you guys how pretty everything is right now. Like, I don't even know if the camera is gonna do this justice.
Look at the sky. The sun breaking through the clouds. Isn't that just awesome? Oh. One of my favorite things is just staring out this window at everything that's going on in the backyard. We have such a great view of the sky. I love it. So yesterday my mom planted potatoes, sweet potatoes, calla lilies. She transplanted chives. We transplanted my tomatillos because they were not looking happy. She planted a rutabaga in a terracotta pot over here for me, and a carnation, and some feverfew, which I've never grown before, and I'm super excited about that. And I'll have to walk out there, have my kids bring the camera out for me so I can show you guys our black tulips. They're just, this is not gonna do them justice from this far away, but they are absolutely breathtaking. And a naughty puppy chewing on a cup. Happy Tuesday, friends.
Are you ready? Hold on, are you ready? Hold on, ready?
Yes.
Hold on, ready? Ready?
Dad, do you think he's back? If you give a little
more than you're asking for your love. Come on, Dad. Come on, Doug. So, I suppose I'm learning a lot. I got to Loctite all these bolts. They come off. See that one came off there. I have to Loctite them down. And you can see it kind of affected the cant on the log right there. But, in about 15 minutes, maybe 20, maybe 15 minutes, we made 4 10-foot, 2-inch pieces of lumber. Hi-ho.